Hi children, welcome back. In the last video we have stopped to this, that is types of roads. Then how many types of the roads we are studying here? Mainly two types of roads. One is tap road and another one is fibrous road. Okay, the tap road, what is the tap road, how it looks and how it is going to be? Okay, so I'm going to draw a clear picture of this, then you will come to know. The tap road is, it is going to look, assume that this is a plant and this is a ground. Okay, this is a ground, this is a stem part of the plant, and this tap root will run from the main branch, will be like this. It will run and it will go almost very deep into the soil. So this is soil. Okay, then this will be a main branch which runs from the stem part, and here it has a small branches like this, very less but small branches like this. Okay, so here one and here one and here one. So like this it has got the small branches to support. See here, taproot has got like this structure. It will run from the stem. Main part of the root will be very long and almost it will go very deep in the soil. So it can hold the whole tree, the longest and the biggest tree, very strongly. Then this main branch, the main branch of the root will go deep into the soil. And for this main branches, from the main branches, there will be a small branches like this. So which can support the main branch. So this like of structure, this like structure is for the taproot. Okay, now I think now we got the idea. Again, you are going to get the idea. See, this main branch or main root will be one or more than one also. Okay, main root and the branches. This main root may be one for the plant and so many small branches, so like this will be there, or more than one also will be there, but it is not more number, it will not increase so more numbers. Okay, so like this, this is the structure of the tap root. For example, the jowar, the big mango tree and the guava tree and the chili, the coriander leaf, the neem tree, these all have this tap root system. How many systems are there? Two systems are there. One is taproot and one is fibrous root. Now we are learning this taproot here. Then what is the structure of taproot, or what is the taproot? The root which runs very deep into the soil from the stem part, and which is called as the main root, and there will be a small branches, those are called as the branches or the small roots which are going to support the main root. Then these like this plants will be tall and very heavy will be there. For example, you can write chili, curry leaves tree, and a mango tree, mango neem, jowar, mango neem, jowar and the chili. So these all are, etc., these all are the examples for the taproot. Okay, I hope you got a clear picture about the taproot. Now then we will discuss about the fibrous root. As the name itself indicates, the fibrous root, this is taproot, this is fibrous root. So here, assume that this is our ground level, and this part is about below the ground level. This is a soil. So from the above level, there will be a root like this. Plant will be like this. We will be having leaf, okay, flower, some other parts of the plants also. Then in the fibrous root, the roots will start like this. There will be a several branches from the main part of the stem inside the soil. In the taproot, what happened? Only one main branch was there, and which was very long and deep into the soil. But in the fibrous root, we have many branches from the ground itself. And for these branches, we may have some very fiber-like small branches also there. And these roots, compared to the taproot, these roots will not go very deeper. These will be very less in their lengths. Easily we can remove this, like this, plants from the ground. So it will not take much time, it will not take any much energy to remove like this. Now we have got the very clear difference between these two types of the roots. One is taproot, how it is very long, very strong and a bit thick. Okay, and these small branches are going to support, but very thin and very short roots are there. So easily we can pick it, easily we can remove it from the ground. So for example, onion you might have seen, and the sugar cane you might have seen, and the coriander plant, small plant will be there, you might have seen, and the garlic you might have seen, and some flowers. And some flower plants you might have seen. So if you just you remove grass, even the small grass will be there, just you can remove the grass and just you can observe the very small, only this much or only this much length of roots will be there, we can find. And those will be very fibers like very thin threads, okay, and very weak also. As compared to this, these roots will be very weak. And they are soft also, but these will be very hard, and these are very short length. They will not go very deep in the soil. They will be just almost in the short length, and they have again, even these also are having the branches, but very small and a minute thread like branches. Okay, for example, I said onion and sugarcane, onion, and another one example I gave you. You can write the many more examples also, whichever I am writing, okay, and grass, etc. So, and ginger also I told. Okay, you can write many more, minimum 10 to 15 examples you can write. But other than writing, simply looking at a book and writing, you should go and search in your garden or wherever, if you have field, you go and just remove some plants.